Hi there, everybody. Daniel Sweet. This is 5 Minute Theology, and we're talking about Anthropology Part 2, which is a fancy way of talking about the study of mankind. To really get a grip of theology, we need to understand who we are, and that is the big question. What makes up mankind? In Part 1, we discussed how mankind is created in God's image, the Imago Dei. Well, there's more to the story than just that, though, because what also makes up mankind, all of this being created in the image of God, of course, is the body, the soul, and the spirit. Many agree that what makes up man are three parts: body, soul, and spirit. And I want to talk about those rather briefly. The body is, well, pretty obvious. This is the material part of every single person. It's what you're looking at when you look at yourself, and when you look in a mirror, you're seeing, obviously, your body. It's flesh and bone, as it's often described. It's the chemicals, it's our blood, it's our organs, all of that. The physical dimension of our being is obviously our body, and it's good. God created the body. He created all physical things, and even our body. Yes, our body bears the very image of God. But you are also a soul, and this is the immaterial part of you. It is the bridge. Your soul is the bridge between your body and your spirit. It is a connection between these two parts of you, your soul. It's immaterial. You can't put it in a test tube. You can't put it in a science lab or anything like that. Many would say that your soul is who you really are. It is your personality. Maybe you're an introvert, you're an extrovert. You relate to people in a particular way. That is your personality. That is a part of your soul, actually. It is your will, this autonomous part of you that desires to be free, to go here, to do this, to do that, to engage in this activity or that activity, to drink Pepsi or Coke, whatever the case is. That is a part of your soul in that it is your will. Your mind and your intellect is your soul. This immaterial part of you, this inner voice when you're reading or talking to yourself or whatever the case is, when you're thinking, when you are being rational, when you're taking logic and making reproducible, predictable outcomes, and your reasoning. This is the intellectual part of you that is the rationality that is in you. That is your mind and your intellect. That's a part of your soul. Your emotions. You get angry. You get upset about things. You're happy, fearful. The range of emotions that human beings have is all created in the image of God. These are all immaterial aspects of you and me, and they are your soul. Your soul. This is your consciousness. This is the place of morality and ethics, to do this or not to do this, to make a decision willfully about, is this good? Is this bad? Do I like this? Do I not like that? I didn't appreciate how I was treated here. I do appreciate how I was treated here. All of these things are who you are. It is your soul, this immaterial part of you. In other words, your soul is that immaterial part of you that makes you, you. It is your uniqueness that makes you special in your own little way. All of these things, the immaterial parts, are your soul. Okay? That's the second part of what makes a man and woman. Next is your spirit, because you're not just body and you're not just soul, you're also spirit. It is also immaterial, your spirit, And it is the only part of mankind that God communicates and communes with. When God communicates with people, He does it through the Spirit. It is without Christ, a person's spirit is actually dead. So without Christ, a person's spirit cannot communicate with God. It is a person's spirit that is made alive with Christ when they trust and believe in Jesus. And it is the seat of all spiritual life. All your spiritual life comes through the Spirit, but it's the soul that's going to be the bridge so that that spiritual life can flow into the wholeness of your being. We will pick up on this more in part 3. May God richly bless you.